Colorado Springs Police Department tries to sell victim's car, then lies about it. This is really interesting. So basically, an old lady had her car stolen from her, was used in some other kind of crime. They finally got her car back and told her that it was being investigated and everything. When they released the car, they did not actually send out a letter to let her know she can pick up her car. That's really bad. So here's what really gets interesting, okay? When the news crew got involved, they claimed they sent out a letter, but what the news crew found is that the letter was postmarked the day they came calling. In other words, they didn't actually send anything. They just tried to claim it after the fact. That's pretty bad for a police department to do, isn't it? Well, that's not the end of it, though. What ended up happening after all of that, the police department tried to collect fees on it and everything. $170-something, I believe it was. It was a lot of money. And of course, you know, the TV station wasn't about to let that happen, so they ended up speaking up. So the fee got waived and everything, but they wouldn't even tell the old lady what the condition of her car was, and she had to get it towed back to her home. And that's just messed up. I'm sorry. So from what I can see here, Colorado Springs has a pretty messed up police department. But are you ready for this? When this happened, a couple days later, they post on their Facebook page, CSPD will continue to treat our citizens with respect and integrity. That includes all prisoners in our custody. So I wrote on their Facebook page saying, is that the same respect you showed this poor lady? Unbelievable. You wouldn't even apologize to her, and you were caught sending out the letters after eyes were watching you, trying to say it was already sent, and the postmark does not lie, which it does not. The post office, trust me, has their dates and times set correctly. Get this. That post got marked as spam by the police department. They are trying to quiet me. Oh, no. See, that was their mistake, because now I'm going to make this video like I am right now, and I'm just not going to let that fly. That's pretty bad. Yeah, that's pretty bad. So, they're trying desperately to mark all those kind of comments as spam, and that's just not right. So I will simply resend that and let them know, hey, now I'm going to make a journalistic video about this situation. I'm going to actually link you, though, to the original story that was originally posted by a local TV station in Colorado Springs, I believe. And it was actually posted on Reddit, which is how I even found out about the story. So read there for any information, just in case I'm wrong on any of the facts, which I don't think I am. You can take a look for yourself. But this is just so interesting. I'm sorry, Colorado Springs Police Department. I will not be visiting your city because your police department is very corrupt. Have a good one.